Reactome also has another tool called Reactome GSA, which allows users to analyze proteomics, transcriptomics, and microarray data. Datasets from all of these methods can be combined in a single analysis. Thereby, Reactome GSA can perform multi-omics pathway analyses. Its main feature is that it performs quantitative pathway analyses, the so-called gene set analyses. This increases the statistical power of the differential expression analysis, which is directly performed on the pathway level. Reactome GSA is integrated into Reactome's data analysis tool suite in the Analyze Data interface. The input file must be a tab-delimited text file, such as CSV or TSV file, where the first column contains the gene or protein identifiers and all subsequent columns the respective samples. The first row contains the sample names and all subsequent rows the genes or proteins. In the first screen, you need to select the algorithm to use for the differential pathway analysis. The detailed parameters for each algorithm can be adapted by clicking the blue icon on the left of the algorithms box. PDAG and CAMRA perform a differential expression analysis between two groups of samples. SSGSEA is a so-called gene set variation approach that returns pathway-level quantitative data for each sample. PDAG stands for Pathway Analysis with Downweighting of Overlapping Genes computes a gene set score based on gene weights that are designed to emphasize the genes appearing in few gene sets versus genes that appear in many gene sets. Intergene correlations can skew analysis results. CAMRA or Correlation Adjusted Mean Rank Gene Set Test is based on the idea of estimating the intergene correlation from the data and using it to adjust the gene set test statistic. Single Sample GSEA or SSGSEA calculates separate enrichment scores for each pairing of a sample and gene set. Each SSGSEA enrichment score represents the degree to which the genes in a particular gene set are coordinately up or down regulated within a sample. After clicking Continue, you are presented with the now empty list of datasets. Click the plus Add Dataset button to add a new dataset. Now, you have to select the type of dataset you want to load. To upload your own data, select one of the options under Select a file from a local folder. To test the tool, it is possible to quickly load example data. Currently, Reactome GSA provides three example datasets, two matched datasets on melanoma-associated B cells, and one scRNA-seq dataset on B cells. Finally, it is possible to directly load datasets from Expression Atlas. To do so, first navigate to Expression Atlas in a separate tab or window. Once a dataset is added, you need to annotate the experimental metadata. This is necessary in order to define the groups for the differential expression analysis in the next step. You can adapt the dataset's name in the dataset name box at the top. This name will be used for all results. To increase the readability, we suggest to use as short names as possible. To add an annotation, click the plus symbol on the right. This will add a new empty column to the table. First, add a heading to define the name of the property, for example, treatment. Next, add the values for every sample that you want to include in your comparisons. Samples without any values will simply be ignored. In the final step of adding a dataset, you have to define which groups to compare. The Comparison Factor drop-down menu contains all parameters that were annotated in the sample table before. First group and second group define which groups of samples to compare against each other. Depending on which comparison factor you select, the available values for the first group and second group will change automatically. Additionally, some gene set analysis methods allow you to define so-called covariates. These are parameters that might cause a bias in your result that you would like to correct for. Simply select the relevant ones for your experiment. Once you click Continue, you will be returned to the list of datasets where you will now see your annotated dataset in the list. If you want, you can add any number of datasets to a single request. Once you click Continue from the dataset list view, the final analysis options are shown. Create Reactome Visualizations is always selected. If it is deselected, the result cannot be visualized in Reactome's Pathway Browser. This option is generally only relevant to users of the Reactome GSA or package. If you select Create Reports, Reactome GSA will automatically create a Microsoft Excel and PDF report of your results. Additionally, it will create a shorter script that allows you to load your data directly into an Annotation session. In case you provide your email address, you are automatically notified as soon as the analysis is complete. The mail will contain direct links to the generated reports and a link to the visualization in the Pathway browser. Launch the analysis by clicking the Go button. If you provided an email address, you can also close your browser. The analysis will still continue on our servers, and you will be notified as soon as it is done. Some analysis with many large datasets, for example comparing 5 TCGA datasets in a single analysis, may require up to an hour to complete. Reactome GSA analysis calculates up and down regulation of genes or proteins based on the submitted dataset. Results of this analysis are presented similar to that of overrepresentation with a few additional elements that are described below. Up and down regulation of genes or proteins are indicated as arrowheads pointing up or down respectively. If the value is significant, there are two arrowheads. The Analysis tab in the Details panel contains an additional column indicating if the pathway is up or down regulated, which corresponds to the average value of all the genes or proteins of that pathway. The color scale in the diagram panel that indicates the expression value of genes/proteins is divided into 5 categories. Significantly upregulated. Non-significantly upregulated. Not found. Non-significantly downregulated. And significantly downregulated.